I am an invisible man.
Several writers in our history have come close to achieving that supreme American fiction. Certainly Melville and Moby Dick, Mark Twain and The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, I would say Faulkner in Light in August, and Ralph Ellison in Invisible Man.
Read it.
To whom it may concern, keep this nigger boy running.
He has a fundamental respect for the complex minds of everyday, ordinary black people. And I love that about Ellison.
I think Invisible Man is essentially a journey story from innocence to self-knowledge and trying to muster, to find the courage in oneself, to make meaning and live in such a world. This, to me, is the human challenge we all face.
You weren't being smart, were you, boy?
No, sir.
Everyone tried to tell Invisible Man who he was or what he should be.
But what if I wish to express an idea?
We furnish all ideas. Ideas are part of our apparatus. Only the correct ideas for the correct occasion.
No one recognized him for what he was. To use the title of the book, he was invisible.
I had not believed that black fiction could be so wonderful. And he showed us that you could do with black life what Homer did with Greek life, what Joyce did with Irish life.
One of his favorite words was complexity, which he'd give four full syllables to.
Now, measure 10 drops of this dope into the paint. What's wrong?
Do you know what's in this graduate?
You're damn right I know. That's it. It's the purest white that can be found. Nobody makes a paint any whiter.
Ellison looked out at this interracial crowd, and eyeball to eyeball, he said, all of y'all, white kids, are part colored, and all of you black kids are part white.
It's impossible to be a serious student of American culture and Afro-American culture without working through Ellison. He's the brook of fire through which one must pass.